afternoon, everyone. I'm Joe Maffei. Welcome to YouTube. Welcome to Combat Nation. Today we're going to continue on with part three of the history of the quick draw system. In the last video, I basically showed you some techniques, how the techniques were done, and the importance of how to monitor someone, whether you have a firearm or a weapon or anything like that, but just how important it was to be able to be grappling or wrestling with someone and to be able to feel and see whether your opponent's carrying some sort of weapon. Alright? And then today what we're going to do is we're going to delve into a little bit deeper of where the system came from and why we use some of the techniques and positions that we've chosen and how it works in high stress situations. Okay? So when I was working with the military, I had a bunch of objectives I had to overcome. One of them was conditions, you know, weather, whether it be snow or ice or sand or slippery surfaces. Today I'm outside, it's pretty cold out here, it's pretty damp, it was raining pretty high a little while ago. So I choose today was a good day to cover this type of stuff. And the system had to be able to adapt and to utilize in all sorts of conditions, okay? One of the other objectives I had were the system had to work when the soldier or the law enforcement person had their battle gear or their apparel that they wear in the field, okay? And you're going to find out, I'm going to show you some of the stuff that I had to work with. Okay, starting from bottom and working our way up, I have a pair of military-style Dates Desert Assault boots here. Okay, I wear these all the time. I have my ankle rig here with my Smith & Wesson 38. I have my VVU type cargo pants here with some deep pockets. Okay, I have a Bison design heavy duty nylon belt with an aluminum buckle so that you can actually hang a carabiner on it if you needed to get pulled out of somewhere. This is repelling grade carabiner. On my side here I have my SIG 40 cal and I have my ditch bag here with all my possibles in it on this side. We move over to over here. You can see I have sort of like a K-bar knife. It's a cold steel, but it's a similar size as a K-bar that happens to be a Trailmaster. I have my canteen right here with a water filtration system with some extra magazines. I have a Safari body armor that I'm wearing right here. I got a Maxpedition ditch pouch that you can just store different stuff in. Okay, I have a little survival blade right here. I have just a Cobra walkie-talkie. A lot of guys would be carrying some sort of communicator. One of the guys, most of them actually, would be wearing some sort of helmet like this. Okay? You see the guys, whether it be a riot squad or law enforcement or just the guys in the military, they're always going to be wearing some kind of combat helmet, okay? So, whether you've got a helmet on or you've got body armor, when you're carrying around all this kind of stuff on you, it's uncomfortable. It's uncomfortable as hell. It's cumbersome and you don't have mobility. And before you even get into combat, it's just having all this crap on you, stuff on your side, 40, 50 pounds of ammo, just weight just carrying you down. It's cumbersome and it sucks, okay? It's heavy, you can't move. When you're trying to get up, when you're trying to move around, just to do anything, it's a pain in the ass, okay? It's a pain in the ass to move around with this stuff on. You know, it's a lot of stress, okay? It's stressful and it's uncomfortable. And you want to put in, you want to add to it dehydration, the guys perhaps not sleeping. You know, most of the guys out in the field, they're eating stuff like these packaged foods, these MRIs, and you know, you get diarrhea. It's you know, it's stressful, it's uncomfortable, and it puts people in a bad mood before they even get started. Okay, so before we even deal with any of the techniques, I just want to show you where these soldiers where they're coming from when they're out into the field. All right? Most people can go home and take showers. These guys, you know, they're in this kind of gear day in, day out. You know, they're showering with baby wipes. You know, they want to sleep in this stuff. They have, every time they want to get in and out of a vehicle, they have this stuff on. So it's irritating. It really is. Just to have this kind of gear on 24/7, it's no good. Okay, what we're going to do now, guys, we're going to go back into the studio, and we're going to show you just how the quick draw system works with all this stuff on, okay? You know, when you see some of the other clips, it looks pretty simple, but you really can't appreciate the simplicity of it until you have all this gear on and wearing all this crap. Okay, so let's go back inside and try some of this stuff out, okay? Stay with me. Mobility, right? You just can't move, and there's a reason for that. It's because the weight distribution on your body now is different. Okay, all your weight, everything that you've been normally been able to do is going to be a little different because the weight distribution is now on your hips. Okay, you have, you know, a sidearm here, canteen here, pouches. Now your hips are very heavy. All right. And you can't move them because things get snagged, things get in the way. One thing I didn't mention the other day that I have on today, I had on the other day, I just wanted to save it for today, was this rucksack, okay? It's basically a Camelback hydration bag, rucksack that I have on. And that changes your mobility as well because it puts a big hump on your back. So one of the important things about learning to train with gear on is that your Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, your mixed martial arts, that how you've come to know it and the skills that you've developed just don't apply with equipment on because your weight distribution, your body configuration is different, right? So you think you can just shrimp out, grab somebody, oop of them, do an elevator, do a sweep, do an armbar. Nope. Doesn't work.